trying to get back on this project after quite a long time. It's been on hiatus for better part of a year, but I wanted to do a video. Oh, hey, it's me, Fran. I'm not quite 100%, but I wanted to thank everybody for the well wishes, both on the YouTube and the Patreon. I thought it would be interesting, although I'm not 100%, to make a little video about exactly what it's like to have a concussion. And it's very weird. It has been a weird experience. Although today I do feel like myself, but that wasn't the case for a few days. It was not what I really would have thought of being concussed. It's kind of amazing what some brain hemorrhaging will do to your perception of reality. There's not a whole lot of language to it. It's not like I was hallucinating or tripping out or anything, but it was like a fundamental shift in like my sense of self. I think that 2 days after I hit my head, I had to take a shower, and when I was looking in the mirror, there was a period of time there, like a few seconds, where I didn't recognize myself. It was kind of a scary kind of place to be. And one of the things that I suffered for like 3 days was that like my heart was pounding really hard, like really, really hard. And I read online that one of the common symptoms of mild concussion is anxiety. And apparently it's a strange component of the way the brain reacts to being injured. So I had all this adrenaline, even though I was so tired that I could barely move, I had all this adrenaline running through my body. So it was a weird experience because the adrenaline would keep you awake, but you just want to sleep. And the weird thing about the brain is that it only ever can repair itself when you are in the deepest REM sleep. And so it made sense that I was so tired and slept so much, about 2 straight days, I really could do nothing but sleep. And even after 3 days, I just felt like I was made out of lead, and I just had no energy whatsoever. It felt like fighting a really bad flu, you know, the way you get totally knocked out. And again, my doctor told me that that's a very common thing, you know, because as your body's trying to get all of the blood out of your head, because when you get a concussion, you don't get the concussion from hitting your skull against something. You get the concussion from your brain ramming into the inside of your skull second, you know. So you get blood, you know, pouring out of broken blood vessels that fill up the cavity around the brain. And because the skull is enclosed, pressure builds up, and it's that pressure on the brain that causes a lot of the symptoms that you experience with a concussion. And as the body goes through to clear out all the blood out of your cranium, the immune system kicks in, white blood cells migrate into the cerebral fluid to gobble up all the blood cells and the bruised and damaged tissues and such. So inflammation goes up, which is why like a couple days after you get concussed, you can feel worse, because the pressure and inflammation around the brain is going up as the body's cleaning house and gobbling up all that blood. So it took about 3 days for me to like start to feel more normal, and today I'm like 90%, I guess, there, although I am still running on low power. So they tell me that it could be about a week to 10 days till I feel 100%. But it's the first time that I ever got a concussion. I'm tall and very spindly, so you can't be tall and spindly without taking a lot of tumbles in your life, and I've certainly taken quite a few. And between a few pretty bad bike wrecks and throughout my life, and you know, dozens of low doorways and ceiling beams and compact car doors, things like this, that I've hit my head a lot throughout my life. But so far as I know, I've never concussed myself till this most recent time. Certainly nothing like what I experienced this last week. So it's a very weird thing. But thanks everybody for, you know, being concerned. I guess there were some people maybe that were concerned that my content would suffer. My content would get subpar because of my loss of brain function, but it's not really possible to work during the recovery process. That's just the energy level is just not there. But another thing people have been commenting about on the recent videos is the new ending theme music that I put up on the videos, and thanks. it wasn't a planned thing. I just, when I set up this new music area in the corner, I was just goofing around, and I just sort of recorded that spontaneously. It wasn't really planned or anything. I was just layering tracks, and I only had like one take for the guitar part, and after I had I started out just with the drum track, which was just a loop, and then I laid a bass line down on that with the with my Jaguar bass, and then I just put the guitar line down with a break in the solo, and it just seemed like about the right length. And after that, I just improvised I'm not 100%. I wouldn't call it singing, but the vocal performance, just a one take thing, just improvised. I didn't, you know, it wasn't written down or anything, but it just turned out to be, you know, kind of goofy enough and fun enough that I thought I'd put it in a video, and people liked it. So, all right, well, I'm kind of running out of steam, so this is about my limit for talking. But yeah, I guess later in the week I should, I got a lot of stuff piled up that I want to do. We'll see. All right, thanks patrons for hanging in there. Thanks too to the new patrons who've been coming by. I appreciate the support a lot. I'm Fran. I'll be back here real soon. So, all right. Bye!
Let's lead off. Okay, now we're figuring out our problems here. I don't know what happened. I'm not sure if you hit by lightning.
Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. Thank you.
brand.